questions? Okay. Welcome back to my EBS class. Do you remember what we studied in our last class? Yes, we studied about houses. In that, we learned different parts of the house, then how to keep our house clean and all. So, today we are continuing with the same chapter, our house. So, chapter 8, our house. Chapter 8, our house. Chapter 8, our house. What is a house? What is a house? House is a place made for people to live in. House is a place made for people to live in. The house in which we live in is called our home. Okay, the house is a place made for people to live in. The house in which we live in is called our home. Okay, that means house means a building. It's only a building. In that building, if you are living, then it is called our home. Okay, our houses protect us from, our house protect us from heat, rain, cold, wind, wild animals, etc. That we already learned. Our house protect us from heat, rain, cold, wind, and from wild animals. Okay. Today, we are going to learn more about houses. That means different types of houses. Today, we are going to discuss different types of houses. There are basically two types of houses. There are basically two types of houses. What are they? Kacha house and pakka house. Kacha house and pakka house. So, house is mainly divided into two. What are they? Kacha house and pakka house. So, first one is kacha house and second one is pakka house. Okay, two types of houses. They are kacha house and pakka house. Okay, kacha, K-U-T-C-H-A. Kacha house and here pakka, P-U-C-C-A. I will show the pictures of kacha house and pakka house also. Okay. Types of houses. That is kacha house and pakka house. Kacha houses are mostly made up of mud, straw and dried leaves. Kacha house are mostly made up of mud, straw and dried leaves. They are not very strong. Okay, they are not very strong. They are also made up with bamboo sticks. So, kacha houses are mostly made up of mud, straw. Then, kacha house is mostly made up of mud, straw and dry leaves. Kacha house are mostly made up of mud, straw and dry leaves. Okay, they are also made up with bamboo sticks. Made up with a bamboo stick. Bamboo sticks. Okay, So pacha house are mostly made up of mud, straw, dry leaves and bamboo sticks. They are not very strong. So you understand what is kacha house, right? And I can give you an example for kacha house. Let us see, houses made up of mud, straw, dry leaves and bamboo sticks. It's hut. Hut is an example for kacha house. So kacha house means it's mostly made up of mud, straw, dry leaves and bamboo sticks. Okay. Kacha house is mostly made up of mud, straw, dry leaves or bamboo sticks. They are not very strong. Example is hut. Okay. I will show you picture of hut. Next is pakka house. Pakka houses are made up of bricks, iron rods, cement, etc. Okay. It's also called permanent houses. Pakka houses are also called permanent houses. They are very strong. Okay. Pakka houses are very strong. They are permanent houses. And they are made up of bricks, iron rods and cement. Okay. So we learn types of houses. Two types of houses. That is kacha house and pakka house. Kacha houses made up of mud, straw, dry leaves or bamboo sticks. Okay. Example for kacha house is hut. Next, pakka house. Pakka houses are made up of bricks, iron rods and cement. I can show a model of pakka house. Pakka houses are made up of bricks, iron rods and cement. And they are also called permanent houses. They are very strong. Can you give an example for pakka house? Apartments, flats and our houses. Our houses are also pakka houses. They are permanent houses. They are very strong. Okay. Now we will discuss different types of houses. Okay. First one is about tree house. Houses made upon trees are called tree houses. You all may have seen tree houses, right? Then in parks, resorts, etc. See, mainly these types of houses found in big trees with the branches, long branches and all. Okay, so tree house, houses made upon trees are called a tree house. Houses made upon trees are called a tree house. Okay, then now we are going to study another type of house, that is igloo. Next type is igloo. Houses are also made according to the climatic conditions. Houses are made according to the climatic conditions. Okay. Houses made in colder regions. Houses made in colder regions are called igloo. Okay. It's made up of, igloos are mainly made up of blocks of snow. Igloos are made up of blocks of snow. Then, people who live in such houses are called Eskimos. Eskimos, okay. Eskimo. Okay. People who live in such houses are called Eskimo. Okay, so houses made in colder regions. Houses made in colder regions are called igloo. It's made up of blocks of snow. People who live in such houses are called Eskimos. Okay, I'll show the model of igloo. So listen, this is a model of igloo. Can you see this? This is opening where they can enter into the house. Okay. This is a model of igloo. You can also make one model of igloo. Can you see it? Okay. See the entrance of the igloo. See this. Very simple. It's very simple to make an igloo. Try to make an igloo, model of an igloo after your exam. Okay. Is it good? Okay. This is model of igloo. Okay. Then, next one is about tent. Next type of house is tent. T-E-N-T. Tent. T-E-N-T. So first we learned about tree house, then igloo, then tent. Next is tent. T-E-N-T. Okay. Tents are made up of clothes and canvas. Tents are made up of clothes and canvas. These type of houses are easy to shift from one place to another. These type of houses are easy to shift from one place to another. Okay, have you seen circus? Have you seen circus? It's organized in big tents. Circus is organized in big tents. They stay that particular place for around 1 month. After that, they shift to another place with their tents. Okay. So, tents means what? Tents means? What is tent? Tents are made up of clothes and canvas. Tents are made up of clothes and canvas. These types of houses are easy to shift from one place to another. Okay. We can also make tents. We can also make tents using poles for three or four poles and clothes. Or nylon clothes, or we can use tarpa, like that we can make tents in houses. Okay. Next one is houseboat. Next one is houseboat. Next one is houseboat. Houseboat is a lot familiar to you, isn't it? Houseboats are familiar to you, right? You all may have seen or took a ride on it. These types of house float on water. Houseboats means they float on water. Okay. Houseboats are very common in Kerala. Houseboats is not familiar to you, and these types of houses float on, these types of house float on water. Okay. I will show a model of houseboat. Please check this. This is a model of houseboat. Can you see this? Can you see this? This is a model of, small model of houseboat. Okay. So boat and a small house. What is this? A row. Row, 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 a boat. Do you remember that song? So this is a model of houseboat. Do you like this? Okay. Next one. Next one is stilt house. Next one is stilt house. Okay. Next one is stilt house. Next one is stilt house. It's a house built on long boards. Stilt house built on long poles, mainly above water. Mainly above water or in dry land. Okay, stilt house is a house built on long poles. For example, I will show you. See, if this house is built on long poles, like this, long poles. Here also pole, and here, and in between also. See, if you are using poles here, and all, then it's a stilt house. Okay. Okay, children. So we learned about tree house, igloo, tent, houseboat, stilt house. Next is apartments. Next is apartments. Okay. Next is apartments. What do you mean by apartments? What do you mean by apartments? Apartments is a multi-storied building. Apartments is a multi-storied building. Okay, many families live in these apartments individually. Many families live in these apartments individually. You all know about flats. Okay. Apartments means is a multi-storied buildings. Apartments is a multi-storied buildings. Many families live in these apartments. I will show a model of apartments also. See, it's a model of, small model of apartments or flats. Okay. See, individuals, lot of people live in these apartments. It's a model. I will show it another model also. This is also another model of a apartment. Another one. Okay. Simple type, simple models of apartments. Okay, children. Let us summarize what we learned today. Types of house. There are basically two types of houses. They are kacha house and pakka house. Kacha house and pakka house. Kacha house means houses are mostly made up of mud, straw and dry leaves. Kacha house means houses made up of mud, straw, dry leaves and bamboo sticks. Okay. They are not very strong. Example also you know. Kacha house example, hut. Then pakka house. Pakka means pakka. It's strong. Pakka itself means strong. And these houses are made up of bricks, iron rods, cement, etc. They are called a permanent house. And they are strong. Okay. And then we learned about different types of houses, that is tree house, igloo, tent, houseboat, apartments, stilt house. So tree house, what do you mean by tree house? Houses made upon trees are called the tree house. Igloo, then what do you mean by igloo? Houses are also made according to the climatic conditions. Houses made on the colder regions. Made in the colder regions are called igloo. It is made up of blocks of snow. Okay. It's made up of blocks of snow. People who live in such houses are called Eskimos. Then tent. Tents are made up of clothes or canvas, and these types of house are easy to shift from one place to another. Okay, then next one is about houseboat. Houseboat is very familiar to you, and these houses float on water. You know houseboat. It's a float on water. Okay. Then stilt house. Stilt house means houses built on long poles. They are called a stilt house. Then about apartments. See here, apartments. Apartments means what? Apartments is multi-storied building. Apartments means multi-storied building. Okay. Then, many families live in these apartments. Individually. And the residence of each family is known as a flat. Okay? Flat. Okay? So, please learn this chapter. Thank you.